Now, your latest headlines and 7 First Alert Forecast from 7 Action News. Sponsored by Henry Ford Health System. All for you.
Good evening, I'm Dave Llewellyn. Two Detroit men are heading to prison after being convicted of a murder-for-hire plot. A federal grand jury found Deonta Belcher and Andre Watson guilty of the crime. Investigators say the pair was part of a drug and fraud scheme. They murdered their partner, Devin Wallace of Novi, outside of They Say restaurant in the Warehouse District of Detroit back in 2015. Prosecutors say the move was to get Wallace out of the picture so they could get more money from the crimes. Redford Township police are looking for a suspected crook who likes to show off his good side. They say the man broke into the Sprint store on Telegraph last month. He ended up stealing multiple phones and tablets. The man then took these selfies you're seeing with the stolen devices, which were then uploaded to the cloud. If anyone knows who this man is or they have any information on this crime, call Redford Township Police. Here's Chief Meteorologist Dave Rexroth now with a check of your 7 First Alert forecast.
Yeah, the sun's faded away here, not just because of the time of the day, but clouds are moving in. Temperatures slipping from 50 to the 40s this evening. It's dry overnight, but the clouds continue to thicken up. 39 for a low by tomorrow morning and 54 for a high on Friday. Toward the evening, first chance of showers, much better chances though, Friday night overnight into Saturday. Here's your weekend. Rain expected on Saturday. Some leftovers probably still around on Sunday. Temps in the low 50s. You got to grab the jacket for the coolness and for the rain.
We have new information on a key road project as part of our continuing effort to help you get around Metro Detroit. It's southbound I-75 from the Rouge River Bridge south to the Trenton area. MDOT says it's expected to reopen by mid-November. Drivers in this area have been dealing with construction chaos for more than a year now. MDOT says the reopening will cover the section of I-75 between Spring Wells and south of that. The other section under construction is I-75 between Clark and Spring Wells. MDOT hopes to have some of those lanes open for southbound traffic before winter sets in. Those are your 7 Action News headlines. We have those stories and more on our website, WXYZ.com, and on our app. Have a great night.
These have been your latest headlines and 7 First Alert Forecast from 7 Action News. Sponsored by Henry Ford Health System. All for you.